Thank you very much, Supreet. It's indeed a pleasure and an honor being present among such an august gathering. And thank you for accommodating me and providing me the opportunity to go first, because I have another session starting at 3. At the outset, I would like to wish all the youth who are attending this session and all the people who are associated with youth building very warm wishes of the World Youth Skills Day. If we talk about the youth today and the pandemic and everything else, of course, we know for sure that all the educational institutions and training institutions have become impacted by that, because we have been used to, since the time of Socrates, of face-to-face, classroom kind of teaching. And this pandemic has actually done things differently. We were already talking about IR 4.0, and IR 4.0 was expected to change everything in the way which we do things. And that's exactly what has happened. This pandemic has actually accelerated the pace of IR 4.0. If we look at particular things, what this pandemic has brought about, the very first thing is we are talking about a contact-free economy, or a distance, kind of a thing which has come in. Distance, in fact, I don't know why everyone calls it social distancing. I feel that socially we should be closer, but physically we should maintain a distance. And that's where it brings training, and especially when we talk about internships, apprenticeships, etc., in a lot of challenges. Having said that, I think what we also need to understand is that there are three areas which are emerging as leading trends moving ahead. The very first one being digital commerce. So a lot of people actually, because of the health, safety, and privacy concerns, are going online and ensuring that most of the transactions happen online. In fact, malls and other things are hardly seeing any footfall these days. Having said that, I think we need to understand how we could skill more and more people in this area. The second thing is we are looking at trends of medtech as well as telemedicine, which is again going to grow. And the third is, of course, a lot of automation. And when we talk about automation, what we also need to realize is that in IR 4.0, the jobs were already starting to become on the cusp. So you had edtech, we had medtech, we had agritech, everything, that we had smart manufacturing, everything was moving with technology also coming into play. I think what is most crucial for us, and what we at Telangana have been able to do very successfully, is use this crisis as an opportunity. We already have been offering programs, especially on skills which can easily be done online. What is most important, and today if you look at the DevOps report or whatever else, 21st century skills are very, very important, and we have already started running sessions on 21st century skills. We in Telangana feel that it is very important that the students should be able to use the downtime well. They should be well equipped for what the industry is actually requiring out of them as we come out of the COVID situation. Having said that, I think what we also need to do is, this is an opportunity for all of us. And that's where I would like to urge all the people who are associated with the skilling industry itself, that can we think differently? We have been given an opportunity to really recast the future, change the future, and look at how things can be done differently. Why do we need to replicate whatever we were doing in a physical medium to be replicated now all over again, just doing it virtually? We have the opportunity of doing things differently. Can we look at things doing differently? Instead of actually sending the person on the shop floor, can we look at virtual reality, mixed reality, augmented reality also to come into play? Can we look at how we could actually help? And there are a whole lot of bubbles that have been burst due to this COVID pandemic. Earlier, we used to only think that only IT people could work from home. But this pandemic has made us realize that people, all kinds of people, could work from home. In fact, at TASC, we have been running webinars from May itself on various careers. So expectations of different industry post-COVID-19. And we are having a whole lot of people who come in, and everyone is saying the same thing on the panels, be it IT, be it aerospace, be it manufacturing, electronics manufacturing, pharma, life science. So we've already done 8 of these, including BFSI and all these we have done. In fact, we are having tomorrow one on the infrastructure industry. But the message is loud and clear that automation is here to stay. Online is the in thing. All these industry people are also working, sitting at their home itself. And that is where changes have to happen. So probably what we need to do moving ahead post-COVID is change the way we are skilling. The only way to survive in this kind of a VUCA world is not only based our things on our experiences, but also strive to look forward, trying to see how things can be done. Agility, adaptability, and efficiency being the 3 cornerstones on which we should frame our skilling strategy for the future. I think with those words, I would like to stop here itself. Once again, I would like to thank Elitz as well as the DET Gujarat, Supriji and all the people, and for providing me with this opportunity. And I hope in the future we'll be able to interact and try to see how we could come up with a more cohesive, collaborative skilling system under the guidance of Sri K.P. Krishnanji and others from NSTC, etc. Thank you very much.